Jerry's been bringing out the hood today. He in the hood somewhere. But,
yeah, love is probably
the most important thing. And above all, love. Really, love, love, love. I mean, that's a cliche, of course, but it's true.
Yeah.
You know,
once again, a Beatles song. All you need is love. Love, love, love. All you need is love.
And it's not sexual love. Like, the kind of love we're talking about can't be put in words. But it's a love that you know what it is and you feel it. I've had glimpses and got a taste of it in my life. And, it's a love that it's a feeling that you never want to lose once you felt it. It's something you always never you want to get back to somehow. You get desperate to get back to it.
Yeah.
It's such an amazing feeling. So
Love.
You get that feeling, that true love.
Love your brother. That's what I say, from Christ. Love your brother same as love your neighbor. Love each and every person like you love me, and that's from Christ. He's teaching that, everybody has love for Christ, or Buddha, or whatever their religious beliefs is, but love each other like that. Love yourself like that first, but love each other like that would be a good way. I think that's what Christ was trying to teach. He's individually loving from himself, but he couldn't teach. Well, I know the Buddha could not teach, he couldn't teach the love and things that he felt. Jesus was trying to love everybody, from his own way and teach them to love each other. Buddha comments on not being able to teach that love, unless you want to learn, unless you were willing to love someone as much as you love, what you consider God or universe. You gotta love each other like that as much as you love yourself as God in the universe,
Yeah, that's very true. So very true.
I was getting both sides here coming at me. It's time to get it
correct.
Yeah. I was trying to get it in perspective there because I was having. But I think that's true, man.
That love is just so, so important. Love everybody. People go to church and said, and that God says, love, love, you need to love me more than anything, and this and that. But not just God or whatever you can love, you need to love God. And the truth is, love everyone, everything the same way. Christ himself.
As you said, love your brother, and that made me say love your neighbor. And he was like, yeah, your neighbor too,
Love everyone. Because then when he says love your brother, what he's saying too is that everyone is your brother and your sister.
Exactly.
Not just the relatives, everyone.
Exactly. That's
what we mean.
Yeah. And then, not just your brother.
That's right.
Your sister, your brothers, and your sisters, your friends, your family, your not friends, your people you don't know. Try some love to everyone.
And compassion. Compassion is a good place of always starting to learn to love.
Buddhism.
Look at people's faults, and even if you see people's faults, and even people that don't like you, if you look within them and see why they're thinking that like that, you feel compassion, that's why they're feeling like that. And then when you see the true them, that beyond what they're willing to show you, when you look into someone like that, then you'll feel loving towards them. I can guarantee that.
If you want to do it, try exercise, like they say, put yourself in someone else's shoes. Well, metaphysically, take your mind there, put yourself in their shoes, their situations, their life. Go through it for a minute.
Feel their pain, their hurt, understand what they're going through. And then you'd be like, they do need love and understanding. Understanding, too, is a kind of love. Compassion is a way to love. Understanding.
Even the worst people that you want to
that would very much, it's important.
It's so much hate and suffering in the world, man, that it's just hard to, it's hard to go against the grain to talk about it. It's rough.
Love. it just seems like something people might go Sunday, they'll go to church and the preacher will be like, oh, love this, love your brother, and this and that. And they're like, and then it's nodding off, people text messaging. And then, like, this is something as a kid I always thought of. And, like, the hypocrisy of the church is that all the people in there just go into church thinking they're good Christians or whatever because they go to a church on Sunday. But the truth is that you're not doing, if you're not practicing loving people all the time, whatever religion you are, you're not practicing anything. Going to church and sitting there in some pew, just sitting there listening to a sermon does nothing.
Yeah,
it's not changing the world.
I always thought it was interesting when they said, greet your neighbor. And they stood up in the church, everybody shakes hands and everything. But that's about as far as it goes. Okay?
Yeah. And then, they go to church, but then it's usually church. People are back to their everyday selves.
Yeah.
Most of them doing, like, they're not doing what was taught, forgetting it all.
Yeah, I can understand this misunderstanding, misconception, meaning well, all that stuff. It's all good. You know what I'm saying? But it's time to take it a step further, you know, like, you know, there's more to do with all that greeting your neighbor kind of thing, you know, it really is. I mean,
so much to say, I guess.
There's so much that could be said on that subject.
You know,
like, we try to do little things, it's the little things that matter. Like, sometimes, something like remembering somebody, sending them a card, like, out of nowhere. If you know somebody that's in grief, like, this is something we do. Like, we're about to do it soon. We have a few people in mind, but, you know, like, yeah, I actually bought the card yesterday, like, you know, because I know what they're, I can empathically kind of see the situation with certain people that they might appreciate, and they need that, like, saying, look, I know it's been a few months since your son or your relative died, and I know right now people are forgetting about you, thinking they're going back to normal life, but I know you're probably still going through pain and will remember it. Like, that's the kind of thing I like doing. Like, I strive to do little things like that. And maybe it's an idea for y'all, too, to do it. Not just with death, anything.
Yeah, just kind of assume that everybody's got the right idea in their mind from the get-go.
That is right.
Instead of assuming that, you know, we got to get through the bad first, you know, get through the negative. You know, everybody, until proven otherwise, there should be no reason to disapprove of anybody or judge anybody, you know, and even after proven anyway, I mean, maybe you should try to go past that, you know, that's the idea, you know, just, you don't have to be best friends with somebody you think that you don't connect well with or anything like that.
But you can still love them.
Yeah, you can still care about them, and from a distance, you can still think about
that's
them.
Right, from a distance.
Yeah.
Very, all right, good, that's
from
good,
a
I'm glad you brought that up.
Yeah,
like,
talk about
like
that.
This is very important, like, you know, like, when I tell people, like, when the relationship and a couple is breaking up, and I'm like, I've taught this to people, and it's hard to hear it from a distance, though. You can love people from a distance.
Absolutely.
You don't have to be right there physically. Love them from a distance. You have to learn to be able to do that. It's so damn important.
Yes, you know.
You know, love from a distance. If you can't do that, you're not going to go very far. When you say that,
yeah,
some of the, one of the
exactly.
First things you have to learn how to do is back off and love people from a distance. Love and let go. Let me say that. Let me check the time. But you got to learn to let go and love from a distance. You can't always hold on to people. We got a minute and a half. We can't always hold on to someone and love them. You can't grab them and hold them and love them. Like if your relationship, a romantic thing is breaking up, you know, yeah, you can still love that person, but the best way you can love somebody sometimes is to let them go.
Yeah.
Let them go and do what they want to do. Give them freedom.
The Buddha said even the ones that have passed on and died.
That's right. Let them go. I strive to do that even with them. Yeah, I try not to think about them. That's why I clear my mind and not think, try not to keep my mind focused on them too much.
But you can send
love from a distance.
Yeah.
You know, you can let them go, but also send them love.
Absolutely.
You know, even the ones that died, because, like another thing, every time you're thinking about them, you're dragging them to you. And then when their thoughts of grief, it's messing them up, too. But if you're sending thoughts of love, yeah, keep doing that continually. They'd be happy to get that. But that grief thing, yeah, it's not the best thing you can do for people. But this is our last video of the day. We love you all. Keep sending the questions. And we'll be back with you soon.
Peace.
Peace.